Hey guys, today's video will be about how I got in APU and my experiences through the exam, interview and the courses which we'll offer here. So starting with how I got to know about APU. One day my school teacher called me. He asked me what I'm doing, currently what I'm pursuing and where I am. So I told him about my college and how I'm not interested in it. So what he did, he advised me about going to APU. He asked me to give the examination and look for it. So from that day, I searched a lot on internet about how APU is. I went on YouTube to see what they offer and what courses are there. I went on APU website to see the procedures, what I have to do, when is the exam, at what time I have the interview, how to fill the form. There were a lot of questions about it in my mind. The first thing is that we have to fill the form. The forms will be on the website. You have to go through it, put your email ID, sign up and fill the form. And at the end, you have to pay 500 rupees. If you want to apply for the scholarship, be sure that you select the option in the form so it will be easy for you to get the scholarship. The form is not very big and lengthy. It's just about your personal information. Where are you from? Where you have studied? What marks did you get in your 12th grade? And about your academic and your address. When you fill the form, you will get an email from Azim Premji University. They will tell you when you have to appear for the exam and what are the things you need to follow. And who can appear in the exam. And if you are in 12th grade and you will give your exam this year or you have passed 12th grade, you are eligible to give the exam. So after filling the form, the exams will be conducted either offline or online regarding the COVID situation. Before it was offline, so now due to COVID, it is online. You have to sit home using your laptop, you can give the exam. I gave the exam last year when there was less COVID, so the exam held offline. I had to go to my center, I sat and write it normally on paper. Talking about the eligibility, you need to score at least 50% in your board exam both in India and foreign. And if you give an SAT exam or you are a Kishore Vigyanik Pratsohan Yojana fellow, you don't have to write the MCQ section, you just write about the descriptive answers for your subjective major. When you are above 19 years old, you have to fill the statement of purpose form to tell why you want to come to APU, because you will be elder than most of the students over here. Let's talk in depth about the examination process. Every year, you can write the exam twice, the early admission and the regular admission. If you try for the early admission, you're not able to clear the examination or an interview, you can still try for the regular admission. But if you fail for the regular admission, you have to wait for another year and you can start in the next year with the early admission form. And if you clear your exam, then only you are eligible for the interview. The exam will consist of English and quantitative questions. First half will be English and the second half will be quantitatives, and the third segment will be really about descriptive component about your major, the major you have selected while applying for the process. So for me, I applied for the economics. So I got a graph at the end and I got 45 minutes to explain the questions regarding the graph. The graph was about the gender inequality in the wages and there were around 3 to 4 questions about it. I have to read the graph and think in economical aspects and write down everything. Even if you applied for some other majors like maths, physics, you have to given some theorems or maybe math questions will be there, so you have to solve them. Talking about my experience about the exam, I have to go to the center over there. I sat down and write about the paper. The English section was not so difficult, but it was very confusing. So you have to read it properly and then write. The quantitative one was very basic of the math. You need to remember all the basic math which you were taught in 8th and 9th grade. So you have to go and revise everything and come. It won't be very difficult math problem which you have to solve. When you apply for your major, there will be a second option also. So like I choose economics and my second option was mathematics. So while writing the exam, you will get extra 45 minutes at the end to write the questions which were in the second segment. So or your second preference. So for that, I didn't use that because I was so focused in economics. So I wanted to give whole 1.5 hours to just economics. So I sat there literally writing, reading the graph for 1.5 hour. Like I said, 2 hours for English and quantitative and 45 minutes for the first major you choose and the 45 minutes for the second major. I used 1.5 hour just writing about the economics because I was so much interested in economics. So I wanted to give my 100% at getting it. Talking about my interview experience. The professor who came to take my interview was very polite. He asked me question politely with a smile. He asked me why I choose APU and why I choose economics and some questions about how will it be different from being from north to south, how the hostel life will be for you. he asked some questions about the major also, like for me in economics. So he asked me about what's your thought about rise in the petrol price. For that, we had 15 minutes debate, exchanging some words. When I say some points, he will politely counter me and ask me different questions. Then how? What do you think about this? Then this. And it was so peacefully done, and he was so polite to me that 20 minutes, I didn't even like feel like it's like a proper interview. It's very regressive. It was so peaceful and nice. Like, and he was very much smiling every time, which gave me confidence to speak everything. Talking about the preparation for the exam, I think you can start preparing 2 or 3 weeks before. So for math, you can just look for the basics for 8th and 9th grade, and you go for all the basics which you're taught in that. And you can refer YouTube videos also to learn, and you can go on some website where which you're taught about the, all the basics. You can also go on the Azim Premji website and go there and get the sample paper. From that, you will get to know what kind of questions comes in. I think go and refer the sample paper and accordingly search about the topics. And for the English, I think you go and read as much as English content you can. Go read the paragraphs and understand it, and try to learn about antonyms and synonyms and how to understand a comprehensive passage and answer some of the questions. And there is also 4-year B.Ed. B.Sc. course also. And if you are applying for science courses like biology, physics or maths, you can go for B.Ed. also. There will be one extra year for you. Like if you have to complete your degree, it will take 4 years. Over there you can learn how to be a good educator, how to be a good teacher. For 1 year you will have field visits, you have to go to schools in your 4th year to teach. So it will be 4 years of course, and the questions will be same for that also. And there will be some essay kind of things at your descriptive writing, where you have to write some essay or some writings which will be there on the sample papers, and you can go and look on the website. As the college promotes very much diversity and peace, coming here will be a very good experience for you. And some people will think about the fees, as not everyone can afford to pay high amount of fees. The college motive is that nobody should get denied admission because of their financial condition. The college offers various scholarships, and the scholarship which covers 100% your college fees and accommodation. And if your family income is less than 4 lakhs, you don't have to pay a single rupees. You will be on 100% scholarship for the fees and the accommodation. For the food, you may have to pay 5 to 6,000 per month. It depends on the college. They can also provide you food scholarship. If you have food scholarship, you don't have to pay for the food also. This college also provides a scholarship for the student whose family income is around 4 to 8 lakhs. Like, they will get 75%. In between 8 to 10 lakhs, they will have get 50%. And if somebody is above 15 lakhs, they have to pay the full fees. I think you should go on the website, check the fee structure, check all the details about what things will be required for you to apply for this financial scholarship, and how they look after it, what they do after you getting selected, and how you get the scholarship fully. I suggested you to go on the website, look for the scholarship, which is one of the best thing the university is doing. Like, they're giving equal opportunity to the students who has a less financial ability to come to the colleges like this. Talking about my experience inside this college, when I joined this college, I was very much amused of seeing the campus. It's very big, and this campus is still in under construction. By the time you join here, it will be better than what I can see. The professors are very nice. You can generally go and talk to them, talk about anything. They are open to talk to you, and they will help you at any point. The courses are designed accordingly to the current situation, current social structure, and there will be more talk about the social change and how we can go about it, how we can change the problems in our society. This college's main motive is to contribute towards the society. So me, I study 2 courses for economics. Like, I have economics as a 1 course, and the quantitative or maths as a 2nd course, and other courses will be like, 1 course will be for how I write and speak in English, and which will help me to write research papers and all. And there's other course like understanding your India in social and economical way, and there will be courses which will be like extracurricular things. Like, you will have courses in like theater, dance, drama, and there will be courses which will improve your strength. When you come here, you will experience a diversity which is so great. People come from all over India. Even my roommate is from Darjeeling, and the other roommate is from Uttar Pradesh. Some of my friends are from Kashmir to Kerala to Tamil Nadu, from north to south, everywhere. So you will get to know a lot of languages. You get to experience to how other people think. You will see about different state culture also. This college, this university is very much interested in promoting the different languages, different cultures. So you won't be judged upon that. Throughout the semester, you will keep on writing assignments, presenting and writing exams. They will take a lot of your time. The programs are designed in a such way that you have to focus and give you 100%. You can't prepare anything in correspondence to that. I think if you are preparing something parallelly towards it, you need to be worried about it because it will take a lot of your time. So if you're thinking about doing something else, I suggest you to like think about it because you have to stay a lot of time studying and doing assignment. Otherwise, this college is so good. I have a better had a good experience over here. I love my teachers. I love this college. The hostel life is better. This is very peaceful and very nice. People are very nice. They will help you. And you can play all kind of sports. And the food over here is not that bad. You can have a good mess food also. There are a lot of things you come and see over here. And you can go on the website and search about it. Go on YouTube, search about it and try to contact everyone. If you want to know something more about this college, you want to know more about Azim Premji University, just comment on this video or tag me there or email me. I will be happy to help you guys. I think you should try to apply for this college and come here. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please share, subscribe and like. Thank you.